Do you ever wonder why your fonts in your PowerPoint presentation could look one way on your computer, but when you share your file with someone else, they could be seeing a totally different font on their side? In this video, I'm going to show you why this is happening and how you can avoid this situation. So here I have a professional PowerPoint template using PowerPoint for desktop. Everything is set up properly. I have the font installed on my computer and I have chosen a theme font, which is Beige Jamjouri, a free font from Google. So everything looks fine on my desktop. However, when I click on share and I try to share this file with other people to collaborate with me, or I try to send them a copy so that they can make edits, the font might not look the same. So even though here right now I'm on my desktop, if I open this particular file in a web browser, notice the difference in the fonts. So here's a Firefox browser. Notice how the font is a serif font, and notice how PowerPoint is telling me that there's an error, even though I have that font installed on my computer. Now, the same thing is happening when I am on the Safari browser. Notice the same thing is happening. PowerPoint is saying that there is an error. And this is PowerPoint, the cloud services. So if you are using that on a cloud service, however, it does work on the Opera browser. The font here looks fine. There is no error. And if I'm using a Chrome browser, it does look fine as well. Now, this inconsistency seems to be due to the PowerPoint for the web browsers. That's assuming that you have the font installed on your computer. So that's why I went ahead and I created this particular guide here. Now, this guide will walk you through many of the elements that are related to fonts, specifically how to choose your font family, what to choose, what to avoid, and other elements on how to install the font and theme fonts. But right now, what we're really concerned with is safe fonts. We need to choose safe fonts that are going to work for all users, more specifically for anyone on a Mac, on a PC, and if you click the share for cloud services. So I went ahead and I tested some of the fonts that come out of the box from Microsoft. So if you choose any of these fonts from Microsoft, you're going to know that your fonts are going to look consistent on all devices. Next, I added some previews so you can see how that font would work, more specifically because you want to choose a font that has a bold and bold italic and can support different characters. So as you scroll through the guide, you're going to see many of the fonts that come out of the box from Microsoft. And Microsoft has also added some new cloud fonts. For example, this is a new font from Microsoft. You're going to find that there are new fonts that are available through the cloud service, but they will also work on your desktop. So all of these are safe fonts that you can use, and they will work for all users. Now, next, I added Google fonts. That's because many people want their presentation to match their website, which is using a Google font. However, not all Google fonts are going to work through the cloud service. Now, of course, with Google fonts, they're free, but you have to install them on your computer. And anyone you're sharing the file with needs to have the fonts installed on their computer as well. But even then, if you're sharing it through the cloud sharing service, you'll find that most of the fonts are not going to work on all browsers. That's why I also compiled the list. These are the fonts that are going to work on all browsers here, and a few more of these. Now, these two are some of my favorite fonts from Google. However, they only work on Chrome and Opera. They don't work on Safari and Firefox. So do keep that in mind. Now, I'm going to walk you through some of the fonts here so that you can see what they look like. But if you want to skip this video, you can go to Magnus Media. And when you log in with a free account, you're going to find a section called Free Downloads. Now, in the Free Downloads, you'll find a PowerPoint customization guide, the top 44 free fonts. This is the guide that I've told you about, and also some theme fonts. So if you've installed some fonts and you're using a Mac and you just want to put the XML files into your theme fonts folder, I have here over 72 XML theme fonts that you can add to your themes font folders, and you'll be able to access them from PowerPoint. So here they are in alphabetical order. Now, I'm not going to attempt to pronounce them all, so I'll just scroll through them and you can pause on the one that you like best. And here are the Google fonts that I would recommend because they support the bold and italic and the characters and numbers as well, specifically for business presentations. So go ahead and download this guide because you're going to find a lot of tips as well here on installing the fonts and how to create consistency with your fonts. So till next time, ciao for now.